This is Openly Hostile Opinions with your hosts, Casey and Jay.
What the hell is wrong with you?
I can do anything I want to, people, at any time I want to.
No, we're cooking with evil guys.
Hey, let's get this party started.
Mom?
Hey, everybody, what the fuck is up? It is another wonderful, I guess, for you guys, Thursday. Welcome to Openly Hostile Opinions. I'm Jay. This is Casey.
Welcome, everyone. How's you doing?
I'll tell you what, I'm doing fucking good, and I'll tell you why. I'm 2 weeks post-vasectomy, which means I can blow loads all over the house if I want to now. I still can't blow them into my wife, but I have doctor's orders to clean my plumbing, so to speak. So
Wait, why can't you blow them in your wife yet?
You're not sterile after the procedure. You've got to clear out all the old surplus stock.
Okay.
So it's either
first in, first out.
Yeah, exactly.
It's like stocking shelves here.
FIFO.
Yeah, FIFO.
So I have doctor's orders to go clear out my plumbing as often as I possibly can.
I bet you it looks like a world war at your house. There's broken windows and shit.
You don't want to put my carpet under a black light. Let's put it that way.
Yeah, it probably looks like tie-dye or a murder scene. Yeah, we're doing all right. I almost died, but that's another story.
Oh, yeah.
We might talk about that later. I don't know.
Shall we have a drink first? let's go ahead and have a cheers for my ability to blow loads again. We'll talk about our... Today we have from Yards Brewing Company, Brawler Pugilist Style Ale.
Yes, this is... I'm pretty sure this is their top-selling beer. Don't quote me on that, but I'm pretty sure I heard that. It's very good. I like it. I've had it before. Here's the label. I think the label is just cool as shit. It's a dude fighting a devil. And it's like old fisticuff style. Hey, you know, you touched my wife.
Bare knuckle boxing.
You touched my wife. How about we go outside and throw a couple? Throw some chingazos. Actually, I wish they had that as a shirt. I looked. They don't, but...
Well, that's a shame.
I know. It's speaking of shirts, we have shirts. Go buy them. Anyways, yeah, I think what'd you call that?
A pugilist style ale.
A pugilist style ale.
Monks brewed it.
Yeah, we're getting fancy today.
Pugilist monks brewed. Well, let's have a taste, shall
yeah.
we?
Ding dong, motherfucker.
It's good. It's got malt.
Mm-hmm.
Crisp.
Very crisp. Yeah, and I've said this numerous times. That just Yards doesn't make a bad beer. I don't think.
No.
It's just everything they make is good. I don't know who their brewer is, but you know, salute you or whatever like that.
Even that damn pine tree beer they had was pretty good.
I know, and I thought that was gonna suck. I was gonna be like, I don't want to fucking drink a Christmas tree.
It wasn't bad.
Yeah, if I want to drink a Christmas tree, I'd drink gin. Yeah, that's so crisp. Ugh, I love it. That's really good. And I've had this before, and I'm, like, so shocked how good it is. It's, like, delicious. I'd definitely try it. We've had a lot of Yards on here and everything like that, so if you ever have a chance to try Yards, I don't know how much they sell outside of Pennsylvania.
I don't know how wide their distribution range is, but if you get a chance to try their stuff, it's very, very good.
Yeah, and I think I've said this before, but they came to my friend's bar because he sells so much of it, and they, like, gave him magnets and all sorts of stuff. They're a really, really cool, like, group of people. And we had, I actually waited on a table once that was best friends with them.
Oh, really?
Yeah. They were talking, they were like, oh my God, you got Yards? And we're like, yeah. And they're like, they're our best friends. And I guess they're really, really nice people. They,
they well, it's nice to support a company that's
yeah,
decent.
Exactly. Yeah, just really, really, really good beer. Like I said, go and try it, please. It's really delicious. And, yeah. It's good something else comes out of Philadelphia besides the Eagles.
Anything that comes out of Philadelphia is better than the Eagles. Oh!
That's true. Yeah, this is one of my favorite beers by them. I think the only other one, I don't think we tried this on the show, was their American Ale.
Their APA.
Yeah, that's fucking
American
real good.
American Pale Ale.
That's really good. That is like the crispest beer I think I've ever had.
Without being watery bullshit.
Yeah, without being watery bullshit, yeah. If I would rate this, I would give it 4.5 DUIs out of 5.
I'm going full 5 on this. This is very, very good. I would drink a lot of this.
Our first fiver. Shit, I forgot party poppers again. I should have been like,
why don't you just store them in the studio?
We need like a break emergency glass. I know they're right outside the door here too in my other room. Jesus Christ. I keep forgetting. I looked everywhere for them and I was so excited to get them. And now I keep forgetting to use them. Oh man.
So I believe we have a special announcement. Do you want to go ahead and announce?
Yes, we have a person to add to our wall of badasses, actually. It's been a really long time since we added someone. That's my riding
board. Present the board of badasses.
We wanted to add Malcav.
These people make this show possible.
Say your name right. You've been awesome. You've been giving us feedback and everything like that. You've been talking about music. And you've just been supporting us, man. We really, really appreciate that. So we just wanted to go ahead and add you to the wall of badasses. Go ahead, Jay, and slap that thing up there.
And now we can't hear. Technical difficulties. We're back.
That was a good slap, though. Amanda must feel good.
Yeah!
So thanks again, man. We really appreciate it. Our third person on the wall of badasses. Finally. we're getting more subscribers and everything like that. And like we said, man, we want feedback and everything like that. He was also the one that gave us the story on the sign thing for
Picture Rocks.
Yeah.
So thanks, Malcav. You're an official badass.
Yeah, thank you very much. Love you long time.
Me so horny.
This is a good tune.
Man, I just gotta... We just need to get that on a quieter loop and just play it in the background.
I know. Like, I feel like I'm in a Rocky movie. I'm going to fight someone.
It reminds me of something you'd hear on the soundtrack to The Matrix.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. We were just talking about that. Why were we talking about The Matrix? I forget why.
Agent Smith.
Yeah, because I watched Hacksaw Ridge last night, which was a really good movie, and I was like, Agent Smith's in it. He's like, what's with all them characters being named Agent Smith? I was like, no, the guy that played Agent, I don't know his actor name.
I don't either. Not off the top of my head.
Yeah.
I can't think of it.
Yeah, that was actually a really good movie. I really enjoyed it. It's not what I thought it was. It's based off a true story. Basically, this guy, I forget what it's called.
There it is, Hugo Weaving.
Yeah.
I can never remember his name.
It's abbreviated CO, and it's when you have a certain religious belief or something that when you go into the military, they will give an exception. And his whole thing is he can't touch a gun. Because his dad was in World War One, and he has really bad shell shock, like really bad, and he's an alcoholic, and he pulls a gun on his wife, or his mom, and he breaks in, pulls the gun on his dad, and almost kills him. So he made a deal with God that he won't ever touch a gun again. So he goes in the military to be a medic, and it's a true story, and he saved like 75 people without a gun.
Yeah, boy.
Yeah, like he sees all, there's this one part where he sees all this death around him and shit. People are just, it's very violent. I loved it.
That reminds me of Walt Whitman.
Yeah, and it was really awesome because he was just like losing faith. You know, everything was death around him, and he's like, God, what the fuck do you want me to do right now? Like, I don't know what to do. And he basically said, well, you know, do what I came here to do, save people. So when everyone else retreated, he stayed there for a couple of days and just ran through and sneaked people down and just saved like 70-some people or whatever like that without a gun.
Wow.
Yeah. I've never heard of that story. I've read a lot about World War II, and I've never, ever heard of it. It's a really good movie. It got pretty good ratings, too. And it's nice because you know how I bitch about they don't really take time to – make character development anymore, and there's some of that in this movie, which I was surprised about. I was like, oh, wow, you get to, you know, they're getting, letting you get to know the character. They don't do that in movies anymore. Fucking ridiculous.
Well, that reminds me of Walt Whitman, who, you know, he was a famous poet and author, but he was also a medic in the Civil War, I believe it was.
Mm.
And he would literally walk between the Confederate side and the... Oh, my God.
The Union.
Wow. Brain fart.
I'm the tired one today.
The Union and Confederate side, it would just walk between them and help who the fuck ever.
Yeah. And that's the thing. He helped 70 of those people or whatever. That's not the number. It's something like that, but I forget. But there was he saved Japanese people, too. It was in Okinawa.
Okinawa.
Okinawa. Yeah, I'm tired. I was afraid to fall asleep last night because I thought I was going to die again.
Go ahead. Tell the story.
So Saturday, I think I've mentioned I use a coal stove to heat my house. Well, I don't know if I was using really shitty coal at first or what, but my coal stove got really dirty real quick, and it clogged up a bunch of stuff. Well, the air wasn't escaping, and the air was getting pushed back down into the coal stove, and it pushed the air back into the hopper and caught the hopper on fire. So all the CO is just leaking out. I wake up Saturday morning with a headache. I can't see straight. My CO2 alarms are going off. And I'm like, what the fuck, dude?
Yeah,
like
carbon monoxide is what it is.
Yeah.
And the only thing that saved your ass is probably the fact that you're a smoker.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Because I couldn't see. Like, I was stumbling looking for the light because I thought it was dark in my house. And, like, my eyes, like, I'm surprised the CO2 alarms woke me up. Because when I first woke up, I thought it was my phone. And I was reaching for it. And I thought I turned it off. So I started going back to sleep. And it started still heard the beeping. So I go downstairs and it's just smoking, and I got out of the house and opened the windows and everything like that. Jesus, excuse me. So I looked up
carbon monoxide, man.
Yeah. So I looked it up what you're supposed to get, and it said you're supposed to get a maximum of 35 parts per million. My alarms were reading 150. So I was getting a good amount in me, and thankfully I'm just alive. Actually, no, I was this close to the answer. I'm just joking. But I'm just happy to be alive.
Well, like, this happens again. I'm coming and getting all the equipment and bringing it to my house. Yeah. I don't want to have to step over your dead body to go record another show.
You're like, sorry you're dead, but I gotta get over you.
Yeah, I gotta record a show, dog. I don't want to have to find another co-host.
I know. Like, who would you find?
I don't know. I can't imagine doing this show with anybody else.
I know. Like, maybe your wife? Do you think your wife? No, she can't because of her job.
She would never indulge this stupidity.
Yeah, she tried to support us one time, and she like posted on Twitter. She's like, hey, this is my husband and his friend's new show. I do not support what they say, but here's their show. It's like it's like, thank you.
That's as good as we can hope for, I guess.
Yeah. Other news though, actually, this reminds me, I thought this was worth something talking about for all the conspiracy theorists out there. David Rockefeller died. Did you hear about that?
I have not.
David Rockefeller, for people that don't know, he is a huge, huge member of a family that a lot of conspiracy theorists think that actually, what I guess you would say, run the country or the world. Illuminati, I guess. I don't know. I don't know what else to label it. That Rockefellers have been a huge family since like beginning of America. I think they were the first millionaires, actually.
I believe
one of his dads were. They're big oil tycoons. Yeah, he just died at like 101, failed his 8th heart surgery, I think. Like, how did he get 8 hearts?
Money.
Exactly.
Money.
Like, it's so hard to get like one heart, and he got 8. He had 8 open heart transplants, I think.
Money.
Yeah, so yeah, he died, so everyone's like fucking freaking out. They're so happy.
Those motherfuckers.
They're like, yeah, he's dead. Yeah, I'm like, dude, there's so many more of them, dude. They mass produce like rabbits. Yeah, I'm surprised you didn't hear that. That was all over the fucking... I couldn't...
I was too busy with the Chuck Berry thing, I think.
Oh, yeah.
If you haven't seen, if you go to our Facebook or Twitter or Google Plus or whatever you follow us on, there's a link to a video. Oh, my God. It is the funniest thing on the face of the planet. I beg you, go watch it. It's John Lennon and the Plastic Ono Band, and they play... On some TV show, they get a chance to play with Chuck Berry, one of the legendary people that made John Lennon want to pick up a guitar in the first place. Mm-hmm. And they're playing Chuck's famous song, Memphis, Tennessee. And they're going and they're harmonizing. They're up to the same mic. And John Lennon's just having a good old time. And Chuck's having a good old time. And they're bebopping and duck walking and doing what they do.
Duck walking.
You know, Chuck Berry's thing, you know, doing what they do. And Yoko has this fucking like Japanese drum thing, and she's banging on his drum, right? And apparently,
she is such a piece of shit.
I know. What the fuck is she there for? It's like, just because she's your chick, don't bring her in the band. Anyway, so Yoko apparently upset that she's not getting enough attention or whatever the case may
be. A woman not getting, that's weird.
Well, she grabs the microphone that's pointed at this little fucking bongo thing and goes, E-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I-O-I- eyes open. He looks horrified.
I would too.
His eyes look like they're going to shoot out of his head. Oh my God, it's fucking hilarious.
Oh man.
And the rest of the band just keep going. Like, that shit's normal to them.
Hey man, that's why they're a band, playing with Chuck Berry and John Lennon. You got to keep going no matter what, man.
Even Chuck, they're all just playing along.
Yeah, because that's probably the sound she makes during sex. He throws it at her. She's like, ah, yeah, yeah.
So she does it again towards the end of the performance and makes all these fucking like chimpanzee noises. And they go off. At this part I don't have posted, but they go off and they do a little interview, and then you go back and they perform Johnny B. Goode, which is Chuck Berry's most famous song by far. I have, if you go to the post, there's also a link to that video. By the time they get to Johnny B. Goode, somebody was smart enough to turn her fucking microphone off. So she tries it again and there's no sound coming out. It's fucking great.
Oh, I bet you Chuck Berry would like slip someone a five. It's like, you take care of that.
I don't know what unsung hero unplugged her microphone, but that man deserves a fucking medal.
It's like she's getting electrocuted or something.
I don't know what the fuck. I mean, love can blind you. And
oh,
shit,
yeah.
But what the fuck, John?
I don't know, man. And that's the thing. John was probably on so many drugs and shit. He thought it sounded like heaven.
He was all into the artsy fartsy bullshit with her. She totally fucking ruined his.
Oh my God, a woman ruining something? That's weird.
She ruined his shit. Oh, I mean, John Lennon was never a good guy to begin with. I mean, I love the man's art. Mm-hmm. I love his music.
Mm-hmm.
But he was a piece of shit by all accounts. Hell, Chuck Berry was a piece of shit by all accounts.
Yeah, exactly.
He had a restaurant and he was accused of like putting cameras and shit in the women's room.
Oh my God. Of course. All musicians are crazy.
I heard stories about Chuck Berry would come rolling into town and he wouldn't bring a backing band with him or anything. He just showed up to the venues and expected there to be a band.
What?
And you better have that fucking band there, and they better know the songs.
What?
To be fair, though, he was Chuck Berry, and everybody knew the songs.
I know, but this is like one of the most famous bass players was Jaco, and he died from being a dick to like some bouncer, and a bouncer fucking hit him so hard he killed him.
At least Jaco brought his own band with him.
I know, but it's just like, you can't be a dick, man. Like, Jesus Christ.
Jaco and his fucking neck pickup only shit. You don't play a jazz bass with just a neck pickup.
God, that motherfucker could play bass, though. I'll tell you what. Holy
shit. Sure could.
Oh, man. Yeah, he fucking, he was a piece of shit. Hey, don't talk shit, man. It's like Danzig talking shit to that one guy.
That'd
be funny, too, if that bouncer hit Danzig. He was like, oh!
I'm not making excuses for Danzig because Danzig's an asshole. Mm-hmm. But, I mean, the dude did get him with a cheap shot.
Yeah, I was talking to Jason the other day. I didn't know Johnny Cash covered a Danzig song.
Danzig.
Snakes? What was that song? Tower of Snakes? No.
No. Seven.
13.
Or 13.
Yeah, that's what it was. I couldn't remember what it was. Yeah, I was over at Jason Ashley's, and he was like, yeah, he covered a... Because we were talking about how, you know, being Trent Reznor... To have Johnny Cash be like, hey, I want to cover your song, Her, would have been pretty fucking cool. But he's like, yeah, he also covered 13 by Danzig. I was like, really? I was like, I never fucking knew that.
Yeah, he didn't cover it. It was actually written by Danzig for Johnny Cash.
Oh, okay.
And then Danzig decided to go ahead and record it, too.
Record it, too. Okay. All right. Yeah.
Kind of like Prince with Sinead O'Connor.
Yeah.
You know, Nothing Compares to You. There's actually, great, you know, a Prince version of it, too.
I don't know why this reminds me of it, but I think it's because it's 80s. But I follow a lot of podcast things on Facebook and stuff like that. There's this huge problem with Richard Simmons, I guess, right now. He's missing or something?
No, that's over with.
It's over with?
He's fine.
Yeah.
he's not missing.
People were like obsessed with it, though. There was like so many podcasts on it and just all the stuff about why he was missing, what was going on. And I was like, who cares?
A friend of his decided that he hadn't seen Richard in a while and thought that his housekeeper had him under a voodoo spell.
I don't see Richard in a while, I just get naked.
Yeah. And he wrote a book about it, of course. You know, rather than call the police on your friend, he wrote a book about it.
Oh, my God.
And
just crazy.
The internet just took hold of it and blew it the fuck up.
Internet making a big deal about something. That's weird.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
I don't know what it is with the internet and afros, but between him and Bob Ross, you know?
Oh, yeah.
But the internet blew up over it, so much so that Richard Simmons had to actually get on, like, the Today Show and shit. He had to call him in and say, I'm fine. Like, I've been doing this for 30-some years. I'm tired. It's me time now.
It was just voodoo. No need to worry. Just voodoo.
He's like, my housekeeper is, like, damn near my wife at this point. Not that he would ever be interested in the other aspects of a wife involving the physicality.
Is it Richard Simmons gay?
He's never publicly come out as gay.
Oh, I thought he did.
No, he just basically said it's nobody's fucking business but mine.
Yeah.
But it's pretty clear that he is. Point.
Yeah, it is.
I mean, he's
flamboyant. A little bit of lisp.
He's flamboyant as hell. I mean, he's known to go shopping for women's clothes.
I know. No straight man loses that much weight.
I'm working on it, dick.
You didn't lose that much yet.
I'm working on it.
Yeah, you're working on it. You are. I'm actually surprised, Jay. You're keeping along with it. It's not that the lose weight part, it's the vegetarian part. Like, I didn't think ever in my life you would say, hey, Casey, I'm not eating meat. I'm like, ooh.
Yeah, because my favorite catchphrase was vegetarian, ancient Indian word for lousy hunter.
Exactly.
You know what it is? I've been cooking for so long. I was a cook professionally for many, many years.
Uh-huh.
And I know how to cook tons of shit, but when it comes to vegetarian food, I'm using a lot of ingredients and things that I never messed with before.
So it's like a learning experience.
It's exciting.
Right? Yeah,
it's fun.
Exactly. Yeah.
You know, I'm like learning how to use tempeh and tofu and things that I've never used before.
Ooh-wee-oo, kidla tofu. Hey, remember that from Doug?
Yes, I do.
If everyone remember watches the cartoon Doug when we were younger, his favorite band was the Beats, and they had a song called Killer Tofu.
That song was catchy.
I don't even know how I fucking remembered that song. I used to watch Doug a lot, though. Oh, man.
I was like Skeeter.
Yeah. Hey, Doug. And his dog Pork Chop, his crushed patty mayonnaise. He had the little. He was sort of a bully, Roger, and that's pretty much all the.
And then Nickelodeon was dumb as hell and sold it to Disney, where they remade new ones.
Yeah, and I think some of the voices were different because I remember seeing that. And I was like, this is shit. Oh, Jesus.
Yeah,
Christ.
The Billy West wasn't doing Doug.
Yeah,
and Billy West is my favorite voice actor.
Yeah,
I mean, he does everything.
And that's another thing, like how you were saying about Bob Ross. He was already popular on the internet, but Twitch, for all you gamers out there that watch Twitch or anything like that, Twitch did like a Bob Ross marathon where they showed every single thing, and then it really blew up. It was getting like an average, say you're popular on Twitch, the average is like 1,000 viewers. I think this had like 200,000 at every time. Like people
it's
were
nostalgia.
Like, yeah, exactly. And it was great. I watched the fuck out of it. Like for like a month, I think I was watching it. And now they're actually doing Power Rangers Marathon because of the movie coming out. I think that movie's going to surprise people.
I'm not interested at all. The only thing worthwhile about that is Bryan Cranston.
Yeah, playing Zordon.
He was in the original. He did voices and shit.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yeah,
yeah. That's CGI, though, man. Like, they have to, but, like, they showed Alpha, and I'm like, that's not Alpha. He's like this little fucking creepy robot. I was like, no. I wish they would have used a real guy for Alpha, but whatever.
Was Alpha the red thing with the little spaceship
robot
head?
Yeah, with the spaceship head. He had the little laser beam going through.
As I said before, I kind of missed out on the whole power rangers thing.
Yeah, like you said, that Jay thinks he was like a year just too older.
Yeah, because Casey's 1 year younger than me.
Yes.
So it's like I literally think I got out of it by 1 year.
Yeah, almost exactly too. You're almost exactly a year older than me.
Yeah.
And the funny thing is Power Rangers was such a huge deal when it came out because I still remember where I was, what I was wearing when I first seen the first episode. I was wearing my glow in the dark Transformers onesie.
Do you know where you were when Kennedy was shot? Do you know where Power Rangers premiered?
I do. Partridge Farm remembers. Oh man, but then it just blew up. Toys, anything you could think of was Power Rangers when I was younger. Like, holy fuck, man.
There was a lot of TV shows that were basically designed just to sell toys.
Yeah, exactly. G.I. Joe.
As much as it pains me to say, Ninja Turtles.
Yeah.
I mean, how many times did you see a character once?
Yeah.
And then they had to make the toy.
Yep.
They would actually make the toys sometimes first.
Yeah, exactly.
And give the toy designs to the animators. Okay, make this, write it into an episode.
Yeah. And that's the thing. Like, the new Ninja Turtle movies, I don't really mind them. They're okay. I don't know. They got their characters right. They're goofy, whatever. That's what the turtles are. They're goofy.
They're better than I thought, but I didn't like it that much.
Yeah, and that's the thing. Like, I really didn't like it, but they didn't piss me off as much as I thought they would. They're just entertaining. It's for entertainment. I thought it was just going to be kind of... Actually, the first one I didn't like because there was so much CGI in it, I got a headache. Like, I remember at the part...
Well, Mecha Shredder was kind of stupid.
Yeah, that was kind of stupid. But, like, the one part, I remember near the end of the movie, they're, like, sliding down some tunnels or something like that, and it's all CGI, and I'm just like, okay!
I just don't understand
why... We get it!
I mean, every version of the Ninja Turtles has had a different origin story, and I'm okay with that.
Uh-huh.
But why the hell did they change it so drastically on those? That's my thing.
I don't know. I have no idea.
And it's kind of like... I'm not Mr. PC by any stretch of the imagination, but, like, Splinter learned how to be Asian from a book.
Yeah, I know. That's just lazy writing.
To say the least. Like, really? He didn't even come from Japan. Fucking Tony Shalhoub is the voice of fucking... We got Monk as Splinter.
Yeah.
And, you know, he puts his hair up in a Japanese fashion, grows the mustache, and learns martial arts from a fucking book.
And that's the thing. That is another thing. That Splinter CGI is god fucking awful, dude. I was like, did they just fucking hire, like, a 3-year-old kid to do him? Like, here's a computer, Timmy. Make something. And, like, that's what it turned out with. Oh, my God. It was god-awful. What makes it worse is I went to school for CGI, so, like, it stuck out for me. It's just, oh, man. I wanted to just cut my eyes out with a fucking plastic spork. So god-awful.
Yeah, it was bad.
Yeah.
My favorite incarnation besides the comic book versions is the first Ninja Turtles movie from the 90s.
Mm.
That was by far the best one. I mean, Casey Jones straight up murdered Shredder.
Oh, yep.
In case you have forgotten, let me
that was this. Like when you were younger, you're like, oh, he didn't even think about it.
No, I didn't get it when I was younger.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, he ends up surviving, obviously, because there wouldn't be a Shredder for the second movie, but he falls into the truck. And then Casey Jones hits the crusher feature and goes, oops.
I know. He was so nonchalant about it, too. He was like, oops. I was like, murder.
It's played for laughs, and I go back and watch. I'm like, Casey Jones straight up murdered him for a joke.
I know, dude. That's why I was like, holy fuck, Casey. My calm God. Down. Yeah, I just, oh, man.
The new Ninja Turtles cartoon on Nickelodeon is pretty good, except for I hate that they made April and Casey Jones teenagers. It's just, I don't like it.
So they're not fucking.
they're interested in one another, but they're not fucking.
Oh, man.
And they got Josh. Shame. They got Josh Peck from Jake and Josh doing the Casey Jones voice.
What?
Yeah.
Wait, is that the fat one or the skinny one?
Well, they're both skinny now. But oh, they're both formerly fat ones.
So we got a coke addiction.
I'm thinking gastric bypass.
Oh, Jesus Christ! He was a fat fuck.
He's rather suave nowadays, though.
Oh yeah, probably. You know, and he's an actor, and he's probably Jewish, so he, you know, has lots of money. He's getting pussy.
I actually think he is Jewish. Peck sounds Jewish, doesn't it?
Yeah. Plus, he is a Jew fro. He sort of has a Jew fro. Yeah, a little bit.
I don't know.
Yeah,
I'm not good with this.
I am. I stereotype like a motherfucker.
Yeah, you do.
Speaking of stereotypes, I think you wanted to bring up something today. We were going to talk about...
Oh, yeah. I wanted to bring this up last week, but we ran out of time. So yeah. I'm going to do it now.
Yeah, this is interesting, let's just say the least.
All right, so...
I got to get in the right mindset for this, because this is just...
Oh, for God's sake. So a resident assistant at Pitzer College... I have no idea where that is.
In the town of bullshit. That's well, where it's at.
Let's find out here quick. Pitzer College. Where are you located?
Oh, man.
Pitzer College is Claremont, California.
I was going to say it has to be California because nothing this ridiculous wouldn't come from any other state but California.
All right, so let's just go with the headline. Campus-wide email tells white girls to stop wearing hoop earrings because it's called cultural appropriation.
Jesus Christ.
Now, before I even get into how stupid this is, let me just say this much. I support this because anything that gets women to stop wearing those retarded fucking hoop earrings, good on you.
I like it. I think it's hot.
Hoop earrings?
Yeah.
I always used to call them slut hoops.
I know.
You just want to grab them by your ear, by the ear and drag them around.
It's starting to make sense now.
So anyway, the resident assistant at Pfizer College, Pitzer, whatever, sent out an email to the entire school about how upset she was in seeing white girls in hoop earrings because, and I quote here, it's culturally offensive to the black and brown bodies who typically wear hoop earrings. Oh, excuse me. Yeah, so apparently the whole thing started when a group of Latino students spray painted white girl take off your hoops on a dorm wall that's devoted to free speech. Then after one white girl said she was confused by the message, one of the spray painters, a resident assistant named Allegra Martinez, felt the need to fire off a school-wide email expressing her disgust. The art was created by myself and a few other women of color after being tired and annoyed with the reoccurring theme of white women appropriating styles that belong to the black and brown folks who created the culture. The black and brown bodies who typically wear hooped earrings and other accessories like winged eyeliner, gold nameplate necklaces, etc., are typically viewed as ghetto and not taken seriously by others in their daily lives. She sees winged eyeliners, lined lips, and big hoop earrings as symbols of an everyday act of resistance, especially here at Claremont Colleges. Really?
Dude. Oh, my God, dude.
Really? Like,
this is the main problem with that I have with a lot of people. Your personal feelings... I'm telling you right now in the real world, no one fucking cares. No one cares about your opinions or anything like that. So get fucking used to it.
Well, here's where Jay gets offensive. If you want to technically go at this about cultural appropriation, technically the fact that you're here wearing white people clothing like jeans and t-shirts is cultural appropriation. Because when they grabbed your ass and threw you on a boat, you wore loincloths.
I fucking love you, Jay. Oh,
was
man.
It right? No. Is it a good thing that that European ancestors enslaved other people? Is it a good thing that we said, you know what? These people are brown. Let's throw them on a boat and make them do stuff.
Because that is the same exact thing I was thinking. So... white people
but
are responsible
for slavery,
basically, or whatever, and they come over and adapt to our culture, and now they're yelling at white people for dressing. Like, your whole fucking culture is based off of white culture, you dumb fucks. I just don't get it, man. And this is the thing. I hear all these people saying about fascism and blah, blah, blah. That's what fascism is. Fascism is when you start telling people... you can't do what you want to.
I got
you
him going.
Fucking retards. I can't help it, dude. This is so stupid and so brainwashed bullshit. I can't fucking take it.
Morgan Freeman said it best. If you don't want there to be a I'm paraphrasing, of course. If you don't want there to be an issue with race, stop bringing it up.
Exactly. You're looking for problems. You are making people racist. You are causing people to be racist. So knock it the fuck off. No one cares what you think people should wear or not.
I'm totally cool with black folks, Latino folks. I don't care.
And that's
but you know
thing.
What? When
I'm
you
just...
start insulting people for stupid shit like this, you're just being an idiot. You're being a bigot.
Exactly.
You're being the bigot.
Exactly. You're being a fucking asshole. And these are the, and that's what I said about these people. These are the type of people saying that we're a fascist country now. You are responsible for it because these are the people that are burning books, which they did in Germany. That's what fascism is when you start telling people you can't do what you want to do.
I mean, if we had gone up and said, hey, you can't wear that baseball cap, that's appropriating white culture, everybody would laugh at us for being dumb fucks.
I know.
And you should be laughed. You should be ridiculed for saying something stupid like that.
You're fucking retarded. And oh, just fucking, where's the flood? I can't take it anymore. And, like, the California thing. Oh, my God.
I mean, you're no better than the toothless idiots out in the fucking boonies who sit there and say, you know what? I can't stand me no N-words that I'm not allowed to say in this show or iTunes will kick us the hell off. you know, I don't likes me them folk. They ain't good people.
I know. And it's just, it fucking drives me nuts. And it's only California for some reason.
Nah, it's all over.
But it's extremely California. It's concentrated. It's a lot of California. It's everywhere. I don't know what's in your fucking drinking water out there, but go fucking get some fresh air or something. I don't know what the fuck it is. You sound like a fucking retarded person. Like, I'm not going to be openly correct, but like, mentally handicapped. You sound like a window-licking, water-wing-wearing, helmet-wearing fucking retard. Go fucking kill yourself or something. I'm sick of it!
Or here's a thought. Before you open your fucking mouth about racial issues and societal issues, educate yourself further.
I know.
Gain some maturity. Gain some understanding. Things are not black and white. They are gray. Things require subtlety.
And here's another thing. I don't get, like, all right, so you're upset when people don't understand your culture. So people start understanding your culture, like fashion from your culture, and then you have a problem with it again? Like, you
there's
just...
no pleasing some people.
Exactly. And that's all it is. And this is why nothing will ever get fixed with this whole racial bullshit, sexism bullshit, because you're going to find something else. Once you get another thing, you're going to find something the fuck else. And it's fucking driving me nuts. Like the gay marriage thing. You got it, which I think it shouldn't even been an issue to begin with.
Yeah, really.
No one should tell you who you should love. And that's bullshit. But now you have nothing else to complain about. So now you're going to the fucking trans shit. It's like, are you ever fucking happy with anything? So back to the fucking, like, so you want people to understand your culture, like I was saying. So people start to understand it. They start to, like, you know, fashion from your culture and everything. You have a problem with that. So it's like, what the fuck do you want?
I don't think hoop earrings came from people of color, be it Latinos or brown people or black people.
Yeah, they come from K Jewelers.
I'm just saying, I don't think it came from that originally. Dude, I'm pretty sure I saw pirates with earrings.
I know, Jesus Christ. Actually, that new pirate movie is pretty cool. It's rated R. Just joking.
Hey, how much did it cost to get the pirate's ears pierced?
A buccaneer. That's one of my favorite jokes. But back to it, damn it. I'm still fired up about it. I just can't do it anymore, man.
It's dumb shit. I know. It's stupid.
And it's like I see African Americans in this country. Like I said before, I like a lot of history. I see them fought so hard against segregation. They fought so hard against it. You know, because back in the day, if you were an African American, you weren't allowed to use a white person's water fountain. You weren't allowed to use the libraries they were supposed to use. You couldn't use the same toilets as them, same washing machines as them. You had to use everything different. And they fought so hard against it. And you won. You beat segregation. Now you're headed towards more of segregation again. What the fuck do you guys want?
it's just people who get their ideologies too far up their ass to understand things.
I know, and that's the thing. They don't understand anybody. These are the kind of people
don't understand that life's full of gray areas and subtleties and not everything's a black and white. Not everything's a slight against you. Sometimes things are simply a misunderstanding.
Yeah.
Or simply things are just, you know, it's not a big deal.
I know. And this is like, I was talking about Heartbreak Ridge. The reason why I like that movie so much, it's because it has a lot of, it shows a lot of what's going on today with this kind of stuff. When he went in the military, everyone hated him. He's going to get us killed. He's not going to carry a gun. What if we need protected? You know, blah, blah, blah. Well, they finally get stuck in a foxhole with him and get to know the guy. and they fall in love with the guy. He had a really hard life. No one knew that. Like Robin Williams says.
I thought it was Hacksaw Ridge, not Brokeback Ridge.
Yeah. I'm getting Brokeback Mountain mixed up. That was pretty good. But so they find out, and, you know, they find out that he's like everyone else. He's had a hard life. He just believes in different things. And the whole movie is based off of, you know, everyone's going to believe different stuff. Everyone's going to believe in different things. Everyone's different. They come from different, you know, tragedies, different families, but they're all getting one thing done together, and that's just living life and trying to make life better for everyone else. But
hallelujah.
But people just
praise Jesus.
Exactly. And when this
preach on, brother.
Yeah, and when this guy's going around dodging bullets, kicking grenades away and shit like that, not killing anyone, all these people are like, this guy's a million times more of a man than I am. And that's what everyone said to him. It was just an amazing movie. And like, when I see a movie like that, it makes sense.
Jeez.
Praise Jesus.
Praise Jesus. And it's like, you know, the one guy he had a problem with in the movie, they were dickheads. He actually, you know, was a dickhead to him. And he found out that he was an orphan. And that's why he was a dick. He was a dick. He was taking his anger out on everyone else because he was an orphan. He never knew his mom. And it's like, he would have never knew that if you just would have sat down and fucking talked to him. If you're upset about a girl wearing hoop earrings, you know what you should do? Go and eat lunch with him. Start asking him questions. Get to know him. Maybe you'll understand, which no one tries to do anymore. They just assume everything. Maybe you would understand why she wore hoop earrings. Maybe her fucking mom died, and that was the last thing she fucking gave to her. You never know what someone's going through, so stop fucking judging people. I'm done!
Are you crawling down off your podium there?
I can't fucking help it, dude. No one knows what... Everyone's going through something. So stop fucking... Just stop.
You know who else went through some shit?
Princess Diana.
More than 900 children, apparently.
Oh, really?
Justin Bieber impersonator charged with more than 900 child sex offenses.
I'm sorry, you're a smart motherfucker. You're a piece of shit, but you are smart as shit, dude. You are a smart motherfucker.
Man, that guy has got the guy in the truck in the windowless van handing out candy beat.
Dude, that is... Because I bet you he was sitting there and was like, man, I haven't raped a kid in a while. And that Justin Bieber commercial comes on, he's like... Ding.
So the guy's a 42-year-old man, and he allegedly
mm-hmm.
used multiple platforms, including like Facebook and Skype, to communicate with his victims in Australia.
An old guy that knows how to use the internet. Yeah. That's weird.
He's 42. He ain't that old.
It's old to me.
It's only 10 years, Case.
I know. Don't remind me. I should have died in the CEO fucking accident. Actually, sorry to cut you off. Can we get t-shirts made that said I survived the CO incident of 2017? I'd wear the shit out of that.
I'm sure we can.
Moving right along, sorry.
I'm sure we can. Australian police said in a statement, the breadth of offenses committed in this instance are frankly horrendous. They were saying that the man allegedly poses Bieber in order to solicit explicit images from children under 16.
Oh, man.
The investigation demonstrates both the vulnerability of children that are utilizing social media and communication applications and the global reach and skill that child sex offenders have to groom and seduce victims.
Groom? What are they, dogs?
I don't know, but the police are warning parents and Bieber fans to be extra vigilant. When
they're still
the
Bieber fans?
Beliebers.
Oh, my God.
The fact that so many children could believe that they were communicating with this particular celebrity highlights the need for a serious rethink about the way we as a society educate our children about online safety, the police officer said. You think?
Like, what? Jesus fucking Christ.
You don't say. There's weirdos on the internet? I remember when we were kids, everybody's like, don't talk to strangers on the internet. Nowadays, it's like, put everything about your life on Facebook. Yeah.
Here's my titties. Why are you looking at my titties? That's one of my favorite things I see is where these women post pictures of themselves and their tits are all hanging out and they're all dolled up and they're like doing the emo
duck
thing.
Face.
Yeah. Mm. And people are like, wow, you're really beautiful. Don't be a pervert. It's like, what? Fucking women. Ugh, such fucking brainwashed pieces of shit. There it goes.
Openly hostile opinions does not condone Casey's opinions. His opinions are his alone. Man.
There goes
not representative of Ho Networks as a group.
There goes 300 of our subscribers. Just joking.
We did lose a few.
Did we?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I don't know what we did to piss him off.
No women watch our show.
I know a couple.
If you do, what are you doing, baby?
Not you, evidently.
Yeah. The only thing that's doing to me is CO2 points. Oh, man. See, that's the thing, man. I didn't think how close I was to dying until, like, yesterday. I was standing there, and I looked down at the ground, and I was like, almost died. Just hit me.
Oh, damn.
Yeah.
So many things I didn't do.
I was like,
have a stripper on the show.
I know. I'm actually working on that.
Oh, good.
I have a source.
Oh, good.
That is friends with, like, every stripper at our local strip club. So this Saturday, I actually have off this Saturday, like the first Saturday ever in a long time. So I might go with this said friend and talk to a couple strippers about coming on the show. That is my goal, is to get a stripper on the show.
Unfortunately, we don't have a green room.
Yeah.
We don't have anybody to usher him in for a segment.
So, I'll give him a segment.
And I'm not thinking a stripper is nearly going to be interesting enough to be here for the entire hour. Maybe
know.
They will.
I don't know. That's what. Howard Stern got popular doing that.
Yeah, but he at least had somebody to usher him off when they started getting boring.
Yeah, that's true. That's why you just beat them. They're used to it.
We just start doing this when they suck.
Yeah.
Thank you. That'll be enough.
Do you know 40% of men beat their wives? That's like crazy.
What?
Yeah. It's like a high number.
I don't believe it.
I don't believe it. I know. That means 60% of men aren't doing their job. I'm sorry. No, I'm not. Hey, iTunes, you said no hate speeches. That wasn't a hate speech. I wonder if iTunes has a...
If anybody asks me for your address to come beat your ass, I'm giving it to them.
You don't know my... I don't even know my address. No, I do. Wonder if iTunes...
It's on your house.
I wonder if iTunes has, like, programmers that look for their name, if we mention iTunes or not. Do you think they do?
I don't know. Let's find out. iTunes. YouTube.
Beep, bop, iTunes.
Hey, this leads me to another thing. You can find us on Stitcher, iTunes, Google Play, YouTube, any of your various podcasting platforms. We have merchandise for sale at our web store. You can go to openlyhostileopinions.com. Click the merchandise link. You can buy all sorts of t-shirts, coffee mugs, hats, anything else you want. And make sure you follow us on Twitter, follow us on Google+, follow us on Facebook. Follow us in real life if you really want a friend.
Yes, please, because, you know, I always want more friends because I have a lot of ones that I'm the only ones that can see.
And Casey's used to stalkers.
Yeah, exactly.
He had ones that left a macaroni art.
Yeah, and baked goods on my back porch.
So feel free to stalk Casey.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Moving right
along. That's a true story. He's not joking about that.
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know if we ever talked about that.
I'm pretty sure we did. About a month ago when we had...
talked about my sex life. For a whole show, basically.
By the way, do you realize we've been doing this for over 6 months now?
Are you fucking kidding me?
I'm serious.
God, it's almost like I have a child. Long enough to have a child. Jesus.
Yeah, except for a retarded one.
Yeah.
We're going to have to nurse back to health.
Yeah.
Fucking.
Yeah, I think it was last week, right? That was our 6 month.
Yeah, it was our 6 months last week.
Yeah, this will be, our 26th or 27th episode. I don't know. I'm having fun.
I think.
You having fun?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
I'm glad people are starting to talk back now and stuff like that.
We don't want no talk back.
Usually when I have people talk back to me, I have to backhand them. But no, I'm just joking. I don't know. What is it with the domestic abuse jokes today? I don't.
I think you're starting to dredge up some dark memories.
Yeah, I think it's just the CO in my brain. No, because I was actually reading about that. Actually,
say carbon monoxide. It sounds more badass.
Yeah, carbon.
It's carbon monoxide.
If I'm ever in a band again, that's what I'm gonna call it. Carbon monoxide.
Nah, I'm gonna call mine dihydrogen monoxide. That's water for those of you who don't understand chemistry.
Yeah,
we are dihydrogen monoxide. Dun, 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 dun.
I was reading about it, and it says it takes actually 18, or no, wait, what was it? Yeah, 16 hours to actually get out of your system fully. It takes 8 to get half of it out, and that's at only 35 PPM. I was getting 150. So, yeah. Hopefully I didn't get brain damage, because it did say you may be fine afterwards, but it can cause future brain damage.
Well, that would explain a lot of you.
Yeah, exactly. But, you know, being on the show and reading stupid stories about hoop earrings, you know, I already have brain damage.
I don't know. It makes me feel like a goddamn genius.
Yeah, I know it does.
I never try to spray bug spray in people's faces and call it a fucking miracle.
I still think that's hilarious.
Praise Jesus, bug spray.
I think that's so hilarious just because the name of it was Doom.
Let me heal you with Doom. Yeah,
you could have picked a better one, dude. Like, should I go with Raid or Doom? Doom.
See,
sounds great.
This is why you got to watch all our episodes.
Yeah, exactly. And that's the thing. Believe it or not, I quit WoW for this.
He didn't quit WoW. He quit one of his two accounts.
Yeah,
that's
true.
One of his two guilds.
Yeah, I was in two guilds, and I quit one of them because that one I raided during the weekdays, and it just got... I just want to focus more on this... everything, the channel even. Like, I thought, you know, I would focus a lot on the podcast, and I have been, but I really enjoy our YouTube channel.
Oh, yeah.
I want to do more stuff. The hostile bits, I'm going to do a couple of those tonight, actually, I think. One or two, I don't know yet. I think I actually might do one because I really want to do another Stories by MS Paint. I had a lot of fun doing that.
That was funny.
Yeah, I had a lot of fun doing that. I just got to find a story that I think's funny to do. Yeah, I really want to focus more on the channel and everything like that, and I want to put more videos out. I quit WoW, which I never thought I would do. But I do raid on the weekends.
Yeah, yet again, clarification. He still plays, just not as much.
I still get the I still get the fever.
We haven't worked out all the details yet, but sometime in the near future we're gonna have a contest for so you can win yourself some swag.
Yes.
So make sure you're subscribing and sharing with everybody, and We came up with a fairly unique way to decide who wins. We're gonna have a first and a second place winner.
Yes, and I think it's gonna be really fun, and that's why I wanted to do stuff like this.
Right. We're gonna have a Mario Kart tournament.
Yes.
Casey and I are gonna draw a name out of a fishbowl out of whoever qualifies
like
for the
Hunger
contest.
Games.
Yeah.
Peter Malak.
whoever wins the Mario Kart challenge, we get that person will be. Mm-hmm. Our first place, and then the other person will be second place.
Yeah, and it's gonna be a lot of time. Fun. And it's just like oh my god, dude.
Oh, I wonder if that came in on camera.
I already got enough CO2. CO.
Well, that'd be your methane. Right.
Yeah. It was pretty funny. I was hanging out with Jay and Amanda I think it was a couple weeks ago, and their kids were over and they were playing DS. I was like, oh, what do you got there? His one daughter stopped playing, and the other one was like, she's like, you can play me. And I'm like, okay. And I started playing it one race. I was like, I got to put this down. I was like,
it was a Mario Kart.
Yeah. I was like, I forgot how addicting Mario Kart is.
I love Mario Kart.
I was like, I don't have the money to buy a DS right now.
And fucking Super Smash Brothers too.
Oh
man.
Yeah. They have, dude, that's a professional sport right now.
And well, it's so much fun. It's like
that is. Oh, I love it. It's so much fun.
I love it how, like, just getting hit more doesn't matter.
Yeah.
You, like, you got to knock them off the edge.
Like an abusive relationship.
Link like a motherfucker. You don't need no other characters. It's all Link.
Oh, man. I used to play that game so much in 64. It was such a... And it just... I had to slide that DS away because it was, like, cracked to me. I was like, I cannot afford a DS right now. Yeah, I was like... Oh, man. It's so fucking ridiculous. It was so much fun. Like, your little kid was kicking my ass.
She was good at games.
Yeah, she was like... How old is your youngest?
Seven.
Seven. Yeah, and I'm fucking 32, and she was kicking my ass. I was, like, in eighth place.
She's good at games.
She's just like... I got in first place once. She's like, you're going to get it. And I'm like, oh, really? Ha, ha, ha. And she fucking hits me with a shell. I fucking fly back to eighth, and I'm like.
I've never hit a kid.
I was like, I've never hit a kid before. No, I'm just joking. But anyways, it was a lot of fun. I had a lot of fun. It was, oh, man, I'm going to buy a DS. Shit.
All right, I've been Bogarting the stories. Why don't you do one here?
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Oh, okay. You mean you're going to allow me to speak finally?
No,
sure.
I went on a rant earlier, but there's actually something I wanted to cover just because I thought maybe it was not real or not, because I don't know how you can do this unless she was outside of America. And I can't... Yeah, the person that posted this was from the UK, so maybe she's from the UK.
Well, it's the Huffington Post. They're generally like a real news source. It's not like the Onion.
But it's just weird to me because I don't think you're allowed to keep body parts when you get them removed.
Well, it's yours.
Yeah, that's true. Well, I remember when I got my tooth... Oh, my God. I hate ads. Speaking of that, a little plug there. But
our data.
Yeah.
Not U.S.
So this girl, I just thought this was pretty cool because I have this whole thing with life is... If anything negative comes in your life, find a way to make it positive, okay?
Like carry your severed foot.
Yeah. This girl...
Hang around your neck like a fucking rabbit's foot.
Yeah. This girl from the UK, she lost her foot due to diabetes or something like that. I forget what it was.
Cancer survivor. It says it right on the fucking top of the page.
I wasn't reading there.
I see that.
It's the carbon monoxide. I'm just going to blame everything on that. I'm going to like drive down the street hitting fucking grandparents.
Carbon monoxide!
Carbon monoxide!
Not my fault! I'm sorry.
Not my fault. Well, she just had fucking fun with it. She got it like preserved and everything like that, bolted together and everything.
What? That looks like a plaster cast or something.
Well, that's the thing. She got it sent away. You know how they do the skulls in anatomy class and everything?
Yeah.
That's what she sent her foot away to do.
I'll be damned.
So she basically was like, you know what? Fuck it. I'm going to have fun with my foot. So she...
Well, that's making lemonade out of lemons, I guess.
So she created an Instagram account and just started making goofy fit of her foot that she got taken away of pictures like that. So then she just started traveling and she took her foot with her.
As people do.
Yeah. There's her with some graffiti. There's with her at a water fountain. There's her, like, she's sleeping with it. There she has it with the sunset. There it's, like, it's walking on the train.
Dude, do you think she, like, masturbates with it?
I don't know. She has a... See, the fall... that's what I'm saying. For people that aren't watching on YouTube, like, she has a picture right here where she has her fall risk band from the hospital, and she has it wrapped around her skeleton foot. And that's what I'm saying. Like... You gotta love her for having fun with it. Like, she lost her foot. What I was reading, and she
said... Come here, bitch. Come here.
And she
Dude,
said...
there's gotta be some people fetishizing.
Oh, yeah. There. Oh, I fucking guarantee it. I fucking guarantee it.
Somebody is masturbating to those pictures.
Yeah, exactly. That's probably why she did it. But she just, you know, and there was pictures of her with on the beach with it and everything like that. And it's just, you gotta laugh at it. You gotta laugh at it because it's like, I lost my fucking foot. What are you gonna do? You can't dwell on it. So it's like, she's like, you know what?
You can't stand on it either.
Yeah. Oh, man. Fucking Jay's breaking a leg today. Oh, man. Oh,
you laugh like a Smurf.
who, me? Oh, yeah. I know my laughs got awful. That's why I saw our subscribers going up, and I was like, really? People don't think my laugh's annoying?
But I'm pretty much thinking they think it's more annoying when you go...
It's because I smoke too much carbon monoxide. Oh,
my God.
I'm just going to use that forever now. Like, when someone asks me for a cigarette, I'm like, you mean you want a carbon monoxide stick? And it reminds me of, like, if anyone ever seen the movie Thank You for Smoking, he's a spokesperson for cigarettes. And these people are like, hey, threaten him. They're like, hey, we're going to kill you. And they kidnap him. They put like 2,000 some nicotine patches on him, throw him in the back of a van to die. Well, the doctor...
do it! Just do it!
Well, the doctor says, well, if you didn't smoke, it probably would have killed you.
That's how I feel about your whole carbon monoxide thing. If you didn't inhale a ton of it anyway.
Yeah, because like when I saw the monitor said 150, I was like, is that a lot? And then I Googled it. It's like, you're supposed to get 35 once a year.
160.
Yeah. And actually, I was talking to a friend about it. When you go to the hospital for carbon monoxide poisoning, they put you in like this pressurized booth and just pump oxygen into the room.
So they treat it like the bends?
basically, I guess. I don't know. Huh. And I was like, so if they're putting all that oxygen in you, like, you'd probably be really gassy afterwards. Because it said when I read it, it said the only really way is just to breathe it all out. So I guess that's just, they put you in a big pressure chamber or whatever like that, and they just
give you pure oxygen.
Yeah, give you pure oxygen. So, I don't know. Lucky to be alive. Yeah. So sorry, guys.
That's a good friend. Yeah. Right?
Sorry, guys. I didn't die. You're stuck with me.
Like I said, I don't know who the hell else I would have to do this show. I wouldn't want to do it by myself.
Yeah, I know. I could do it with. I would just make a cut out of me. Or you should do what that woman did. Get me sent away and get my skeleton and just sent me here.
I'll just take old clips of you and have a soundboard, Casey.
Yeah.
What do you think about that, Casey?
Money.
Actually, if you died, I'd probably do that. I'd just have a huge soundboard and just be like, oh, really?
Money.
Yeah.
Dude, if you ever go on vacation or something, that's what I'm doing for that episode. I'm not getting a co-host. I'm just going to fucking do soundboard Casey.
Yeah, I am going on vacation, but I don't know how that's going to work out yet. But yeah, that's not till like a year from now. So whatever.
Yeah, we got to figure that out.
Yeah.
You're the editing guy.
I know. That's the thing.
That'd be hard.
But with YouTube.
My editing sucks. You've seen the Wired Wednesday videos.
They're bad. Hey, editing's no joke, dude. That shit's fucking, it's tough, man.
It's partially because the computer we record and edit on is beastly, and yeah. I don't have that.
I know, because like when we first started doing this, Jay's like, do you really need that much time for editing? I'm like, yeah, it's a pain in the ass. He's like, oh, okay, whatever. And he started editing videos. He's like, I want to fucking kill myself. I'm like, yeah, sucks.
We originally intended, if you watch a couple of our first episodes, we say we're going to have videos out on Wednesday.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the editing process assured us that that was not going to occur.
Yeah. It's just, and
that's why videos are now Thursdays.
Yeah, it just sucks. And the thing is I've gotten pretty good at editing part because of the practice and just doing them. It's the fucking, the rendering, that takes 2-3 hours. Mm. And when Windows updates in the middle of it, twice.
You could turn that off, you know.
I didn't even think of it. I was just, I'm just thinking about getting that episode out, you know what I mean? And it takes 2-3 hours to upload it on YouTube. And then
we usually get our podcast out on Wednesday, which is nice. So if you, you know, if you're driving to work and listening to us, you can usually have that by, you know, Thursday morning.
Yeah, the audio only is really easy. It takes like 45 seconds to a minute to render the audio. And then I send that to Jay on Wednesday, and he gets that out pretty quick. But it's just the video. Oh, video. Just, ugh.
Yeah, you can also, if you're a video only kind of person, you should definitely look into doing a podcasting. Like if you, almost all cars nowadays have an auxiliary input.
Mm-hmm.
You can download podcasts to your phone and just play them on your way back and forth to work. It's better than listening to whatever you have in your local area, Bob and Tom or.
Yeah. We have a couple of friends like Tigger. I don't know if Tigger has ever listened to podcasts before. Shane, he's actually one of Patreon supporters. Thank you, Shane, again for that. Love you long time. And that's, I don't think they've ever listened to podcasts before. I could be wrong on that, but it's like they listen to it while they work. Shane has about an hour drive to work. He listens to it, and Tigger is a truck driver. So that's how they enjoy it. And he just I got to respond to him. I was too busy fixing my coal stove yesterday, but he responded to me yesterday. He must have just watched the episode where we talked about the teacher doing the cartwheel.
Who, Tigger?
Yeah. He's like, is there a video? I'm like, no.
No, I that's what I said. Like, really? There wasn't one kid with a cell phone?
I know.
Failed.
Thanks again, guys, for listening to it and everything like that.
We really appreciate all of you. We appreciate all the listens. We get hundreds of audio listens every week. We get, we've got over 600 subscribers on YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
We appreciate it all, so thank you very much for that. Thanks for listening. You know, this is a dumb little show we started in our spare time, and we're glad somebody enjoys it besides us.
Yeah, exactly. Thank you. We thought we'd have maybe 5 subscribers by now.
So,
and when we hit 1,000, I am using fucking party poppers.
Telling you, you just need like a in case of party break glass sign.
I'm actually gonna do that. I think
that'd
but,
be funny.
Yeah, I think that's all the time we have though. I got to do a bunch of stuff today. I got to go to the store and buy some hoop earrings.
I got to pee because I have a bladder the size of an acorn.
Yeah. So thanks again, everyone, for listening. I hope you enjoyed my woman abuse jokes today.
He's awful, isn't he?
Yeah, I am. I'm really tired. Like I told Jay, I think I was afraid to go to bed last night because I was going to die.
Of course, last night for him is like 8 in the morning.
Yeah, I remember looking at the clock. It was about 9:30 this morning. I think I finally got to bed. And I woke up at 11 to get ready for the show and everything. And I texted Jay. I was like, I was afraid to go to bed last night, I think. Because I was supposed to pick him up at 11. I was like, I'm running a little late. Oh, God. But, yeah. So, thanks again for everyone for listening. Have a good one. Don't beat your wife and wear hoop earrings. Have a good one. See you later.
Bye.
Bye, you guys.
Bye, you guys.
This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. We are available on YouTube, Google Play, iTunes, and your favorite podcast app. Be sure to like, subscribe, rate, and comment. If you want to help make all this possible, become a patron at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions.
Good morning!
Morning!
Good morning!
Oh, and in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.